How do you know the difference between love bombing and romance? Well, that's up to you. And what's important in a new relationship is having a comfort level and knowing that if you're not needy and if you're not empty, you're not going to accept somebody to come straight into your life immediately because you don't even know their values and their character yet. So by checking in with your own comfort levels, if somebody's coming on really hard and fast, you're going to say, slow down. I don't even know you yet. This is all lovely, the flowers and the dinners, but I'm not always available. I'm not going to have you straight away into my house and into my life. You're going to say, slow down. Now, somebody who has got integrity and they've got a solid enough inner being to be able to respect your boundaries, they will slow down. They will respect that. They'll back off the pace. They'll make sure that you give you space for your life, and they're not going to say something silly like, I'm falling in love with you within a week or two, or I know you're my soulmate, or I've had dreams about you, or I had readings about you. That's not what healthy, solid people do, because ideally they're taking their time to see what your values and character are. They're not just in obsession and attraction. They're actually looking at, for a potential life partner, does this person have the characteristics, the values, the ideas, the application to themselves and their life to be a healthy person to be with? Okay, it's only going to be a codependent, unhealed, empty, needy person who hasn't done the inner solid work on themselves, or a narcissist who's going to go too fast. Now, if it's a narcissist and if it's love bombing, there's a very powerful way you will know it is that, is because they're going to resent you pulling them up. When a narcissist is on a high and they're on a direction and they're going and doing what they want to do, if you try to put an end to that, if you hold them to account and spoil their fun and their disappointment, they're going to resent you, and they could even become quite vengeful. So what they'll try to do is confuse you, degrade you, make you distrust yourself. They may gaslight you. So it'll be comments like, there's something wrong with you and you've got problems and insecurities and fears from your past to not be able to recognize a great person coming into your life. You may be accused of being gay and not attracted to the opposite sex. There could be all sorts of things that are pulled. And if the narcissist really wants to try and get you to drop that boundary, they may say something like, well, I've got a whole lot of other people that I've started dating who don't have the fears and the insecurities that you do, and maybe I'd be better off dating them. So that they hope your abandonment fear or your fears of lack, and maybe I'm not going to meet somebody like this again. Maybe I'm going to lose this opportunity, you know. And if they can trigger you really early into handing away your boundary and distrusting yourself and going against your intuition and your understanding of what's safe and comfortable for you, well, then that's really dangerous, because they know so early in the relationship how to control you, how to get their way, and how to make you give up pieces of yourself. So anyway, I hope that this has explained the difference between romance and love bombing. And please know, romance is beautiful. Absolutely, that's a human desire and it's gorgeous and a very important part of courting. We should not throw the baby out with the bathwater. You should want to be romanced. That's a stunning thing to experience. But you will know it's healthy when you can say to somebody, slow down. Because we're enjoying some courting, and romance is not sex. Romance is courting in the early days. Okay, and make sure that you know the difference. It's very important. I hope this helps. Okay, lots of love. Bye-bye.